I'm excited.
Right, there's an easy trick to make your lawn pop with the best odds that will survive a lot of our wacky weather we've been having. We just saw a 7-day, right? Melinda Myers, gardening expert, is live with our little garden moment.
You're right.
Live to show why native plants may be perfect to add to your landscape right now and also beneficial to your pocketbook in the end. Good morning to you.
Good morning. Good morning. We've had a lot of rain this year, as we all know. And one of the benefits of using native plants is they have deep roots and they break up the soil surface. So when we have all this rain, it helps the rain go into the soil instead of run off into our storm sewers. And so then we're putting it back in, the plant roots, the soil, filter all the impurities out before it goes to our groundwater. So it helps to keep our waterways clean, but it also helps you create beautiful gardens. And Fresh Coast Guardians has a website that has great tips on how to do this and other things. So a couple things. I brought along a few native plants. Okay. And sometimes people think, well, I can't, that's too wild. It won't work in my landscape.
It looks like bleeding hearts.
It kind of does. It's actually columbine. On the tall one, thank you. The tall one, I picked that this morning from my garden.
Oh.
And so one of the things
you can do. Of course she did. Of course she did.
And so the hummingbird. Birds love this. These are filled with nectar, so the hummingbirds and butterflies will come and visit and sip the nectar. So you're bringing in butterflies, hummingbirds, all the things that make your garden beautiful and enjoyable. And that's great for the early visitors because there's not a lot blooming early in the season, so that will help. Full sun to part shade. The other smaller blooming pink flower is prairie smoke, and those are the blooms, and then the seed pods look like smoke. And I have these mixed with cultivated plants in my garden. So you don't have to have a garden just full of natives. Some people think, I don't want a prairie in my yard. But yes, thank you. And it's wonderful because it's only about maybe 12 inches tall when it's in bloom, maybe a little shorter.
Right, because tulips don't last very long.
Exactly. So, you know, I'll tell you, the daffodils and tulips gave me a lot of joy. I made it through winter. But you want things that come throughout the season for us to enjoy, but also for the wildlife. So these are early bloomers. I also brought along some other things as well. Some of our native prairies like compass plant and the grasses like prairie drop seed.
I didn't know this one was native either.
Yeah, this is May apple. And so this is great for those with shade. So
love
if you've got a lot
like
of shade, a little flower, and then it'll form a little green apple.
Oh.
And so they're beautiful. They look very tropical, don't
they? It does. I feel like I'm back in Hawaii.
Yeah, exactly.
In a very miniature form.
Exactly. Now, I love to invest in my landscape. It's what I get to do for a living. And so buying plants is one way, but you can extend your budget by buying seeds as well.
Right, because sometimes people are on a budget.
Exactly, and if you have a large landscape or you want to extend your budget, so there's lots of good quality seeds. Look for someplace local. Wisconsin has a lot of good prairie nurseries that sell plants and or seeds. I like to buy individual plants because then I know what I'm getting.
Oh, good.
Some of the wildflower mixtures don't have native plants to our area. They may be native to North America.
Okay.
And so buying something that you know is native here from a local source, you're going to have better results. You could start these indoors. I should have done that a few weeks ago. You know, just start them indoors or plant them right outside in your garden. These are perennials. They'll come back year after year.
That's exciting.
It is. Now, they're not going to bloom this first year, but they'll bloom next year and for years to come. Oh, so patience is one of the lessons
we learn in gardening.
It is, for sure. I'm sure. Yeah, you have a lot of patience with us. You know, and for more information on landscaping and even, you know, to figure out which seeds to get, we have it at tmg4.com. Melinda Myers provided us an organization and a website that will help. And, you know, always look for Melinda on Saturdays on Live at Daybreak. She always has her garden moment.
Melinda's gardening moment.
All right, we'll get a check of our weather outside after this. Thanks, Melinda.
Thank you.